We're live, just so you know, on Facebook.
Oh, look, it's facing the other way.
Oh, shoot! Hold on, guys. Hold on. Hold on. I don't want to be on camera.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Hey, hold on. Nails, maybe. Technology, no.
Not our strong suit.
That's our first blooper.
Our little blooper.
You know what? We're waiting. We're trying to coordinate Facebook and Instagram at the same time.
So there we go.
Okay, we're good. Yay!
Okay, hold on. Hold on, guys. I gotta try and get on. I am gonna. Oh.
Okay.
Nope. I think we're okay.
We have 7 viewers. Woo! Woo! Katrina Owen says hi, girls.
Hi.
So I don't know. Our idea here is if you weren't with us on Thursday, we kind of told everybody that we'd be recording Thursday and posting it to YouTube. And clearly, technology is not our thing. So we weren't able to do it. So we thought we'd kind of get together with everybody again today. So, you were going to say something?
Oh, I think Christina's going to, and Amy are going to be on Instagram trying to keep up with the questions. I'll be on our Facebook page trying to keep up with the questions. So we're just going to jump back and forth, I guess.
Yeah, and I'll just sit here.
And look beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome. And look at this one.
And we'll answer as many questions.
And then sometimes say hi to this one.
Okay.
Camera one and camera two.
Aw, Susan the surf is here and she says you girls look so
pretty. Oh, thanks.
Hi. Oh, so our idea here was we kind of thought that it would be fun to be able to support everybody in a way that we can't do when we're doing live demos, mm-hmm. because it's very distracting, and this way we can kind of keep on top of any questions that come up, and just kind of try something a little bit different and see if we end up getting a lot of people saying, no, I'd rather see live demos, I don't want to listen to you guys talk and be silly. Then
fair
that's
enough.
What we'll do.
Right?
Yeah. Sounds right. Sounds right. So has anybody got any questions for us? Okay, so should we make up, we can make up our own and go and address some of the questions that were asked us on Thursday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Katrina said, Tashi, your hair looks hot, hot, hot today.
Oh, it does. Well, she just had it done.
Literally, guys, I just got here.
Yeah.
I walked in because I was running late, so they could set everything up. No,
that's why we're running late, because Natasha was running late.
I had to get my hair done.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have a question on where our name came from. So let's start there, Yvonne.
Oh, well, we kind of addressed that on Thursday, too. That was something that was asked.
Absolutely.
Ugly Duckling.
Yeah.
Well, it's a combination of things, actually. I'm a bit of an animal freak.
Yes, that's true.
I had ducks since I was a little girl, and I was saying the other day, I was that weird teenager that used to take my little duck swimming to Thetis Lake.
She did.
I thought, yeah, I really did, and I thought it was quite normal. And I think, actually, we were camping with a friend, and he said, you know, if you do another line again, you should call it Ugly Duckling. And, mm-hmm. and it was one of those things where, you guys know, when I first brought up the name, I was kind of like, oh, what do you think
of
Ugly Duckling?
Bit.
And I would tell people, oh, it's Ugly Duckling. But we just thought, I wanted something different, mm-hmm. you know, yeah. and that suited us.
And that's unique,
we're kind
for
of
sure.
Not your... We like to have fun, so some of this, we
Absolutely.
Like to have fun with the stuff we've done. So.
Totally. Fun is an understatement.
That is true, that is true.
I have one question here from Melissa Vince on Facebook, and she's asking when the next class with Sarah from Get Buff Nails is. Well, Melissa, you're in luck.
October.
Mm-hmm. October. We have our Ugly Duckling 5K, a marathon of education, coming up in October. Mm-hmm. Sarah Elmes, Get Buff Nails, will be here along with two very, very talented nail artists from Russia.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And along, actually, we've got a big lineup of really talented artists mm-hmm. that are going to be here from all over, you know, Jamaica, Bahamas, South
Everywhere.
America. We've got a lot of people.
Yeah.
Where else have we got? Somebody's just contacted from Iceland.
It world. I think we have somebody from every little corner.
Yeah, so yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun, but it is 5 full days, mm-hmm. and we are almost sold out. So yeah,
that's true.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Great. That happened quickly.
It did.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it did. We have a question here. Regarding private messaging over the weekends, I guess we'll just address anyone who places orders over the weekend, how that works with our shipping.
Private messaging or emailing?
We just had a question here that someone had just messaged us today but had no reply. And it's just interested in products. So I just thought we'd clarify.
Today?
Yeah, just how we, you know, over the weekends we will reply Monday, typically, and any orders that are placed past, I guess, what time usually on Friday
will noon, be past, yeah, noon.
Past noon will be shipped out for Monday.
Any orders that come in Friday will ship out Monday.
Yes.
But if they're past noon, they might not make it till Tuesday.
Correct.
Depends how busy we are.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think the other thing is with weekends is that we do work a lot of long hours, and we do often will answer on weekends, but we're not committed to weekends because mm-hmm. we work a lot of long days, a lot of nights, we've got a lot going on, so we try and take care of everybody as fast as we can.
We do.
And if you're ever not getting a response, definitely Monday to Friday, phone us.
Absolutely.
If you're really feeling like... you need us right away.
Absolutely. And we just got a compliment saying that we have the best shipping and it comes quickly and is packaged beautifully. So that's nice to hear.
Great.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You got something there?
Nothing yet. Everybody's okay. Just relaxing on Facebook, it looks like. We're pretty quiet over there.
Where will the 5K course take place?
In Victoria.
Victoria, BC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For those of you that don't know, it's just north of Seattle. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, we're on a little island here, Vancouver Island, and the class will be in town here, and I had a thought on that. It's the end of the day for us. I get a little tired at this time of day.
We've kind of been saying whoever wants to come is interested in coming. It's going to be like a little retreat,
yeah,
have a little getaway.
Absolutely.
Victoria is very beautiful if you haven't been here, mm-hmm. and actually where we're holding the class, there's a beautiful waterfall, just like a 5-minute little walk down a trail. The area out here in Machosen is absolutely beautiful if you like walking and hikes and stuff like that. So,
mm-hmm. yeah, that's
a great
point.
Yeah.
We had a few questions on Thursday too about shipping, people wanting to buy international. We do ship internationally every day mm-hmm. To the US, to Canada. I know people were concerned about US for shipping costs. If it's under $150 to the US, and that's Canadian dollars we're talking, so like I was saying, that's about $10 US. Okay, not really.
It's a pretty good deal.
If it's under $150, then the shipping is $15 flat. Mm-hmm. That's for Canada and US. If it's over $150, then we don't charge for shipping.
Melissa Rose Vince again asks us, will you be expanding so your products will be available to purchase in stores on the mainland? I think we kind of covered this the other day when we did this, and as far as I know, we'll kind of be taking care of Canada. We do have distributors in Saskatchewan, Saskatoon, correct?
Edmonton, yeah.
And Edmonton and Calgary. Mm-hmm. Purple is in Edmonton and Calgary, and Canwest is mm-hmm. in Saskatchewan. And then we kind of take care of the rest. And we have Ugly Duck in Australia too.
And we won't, as far as being in stores, we are actually a professional only line.
Yes.
And as far as expanding, we'll be expanding our products. We're continually adding new products. And what we do here is we try and we're using products that we like, what we as professionals like, that work well for us, and we are... And taking it a little bit beyond, because we want to have products that are really beautiful, that we're proud of.
Absolutely.
That have a little bling.
A little something.
Someone asked if we ship to the UK.
We do. We ship internationally. Mm-hmm. We ship all over the world.
We do.
We have a distributor in Australia right now.
Yes, we do. Get buffed now. Get buffed. I'm thinking of the 5K. Sorry. Somebody just We have Ugly Duckling Nails Australia distributing for us over there in that part of the world too. Mm-hmm. I do have, sorry, Amy.
Nope.
You go, Amy. Or Natasha.
Stephanie Lilly on Facebook asked, do you have to be a fully certified nail tech to take the 5K course, or can students take it as well? You can be a student and take the course, absolutely. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a great opportunity, I think, for students to take that.
Totally.
And good for you for wanting to take education so early like that. That's really awesome. So I think there actually is somebody coming that is either still in school or will just have graduated.
Well, there you go. It's a
great opportunity to come and learn as much as you can in a short period of time from some really talented people.
And I will quickly elaborate on that, because I remember when I was actually in nail school as well, I took an advanced training at a show that I attended, and I just felt that it kind of gave me that extra little boost, confidence, and I just felt that it really helped me. So, yes.
Well, training, because we have all levels of experience coming to the class, from actually a student to very, very experienced, talented nail techs. Mm-hmm. And I don't think it matters what level you're at this class, especially some of the techniques that'll be taught. Mm-hmm. Obviously, there's going to be people who will be more advanced than others, but everybody will walk away with something.
For sure.
And that's the goal, is it's always to be successful and do well and keep inspired in the industry, you want to keep educating yourself.
Absolutely.
I mean, even these two phenomenal artists are continually, but you two are always taking
because we love it. It's awesome for us. It's our passion for sure. Because
I make you.
Yeah, well, sure.
It's like 50-50. Partially too, like I've had people private message me before saying, you know, I'm kind of in this weird place right now. I'm really not feeling motivated or inspired or anything like that. And my first thing I always suggest is take a class, whether it's the Ugly Duckling 5K, or a 4-hour course, or even something online. There's great things online too, just to kind of reignite that spark and that inspiration for you.
Really, 100%. Everybody needs it, I believe.
For sure.
Yvonne.
Yes.
Do you ever wear pantyhose? Not you personally. They want to know if any of us wear pantyhose.
Oh. With our nails?
Or pantyhose. With our nails.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But you know what? The thing is, the trick is to, you got to just use the pads of your fingers.
Yeah, you learn how to work it. And you know what?
We're going
to
make a video.
Watch out for how to...
Christina's going to demo how to put pantyhose on herself.
Yes.
And I'm going to demo the thin, biodegradable doggy bags.
And Natasha's going to demonstrate how to wipe your bum properly.
Yeah,
that's a given. I knew I was going to make the poopy job.
Absolutely.
I knew it.
Okay, so another question. What size brush do you use for fine hand painting nail art?
Oh, let Natasha answer that one.
Wow. Just to think about it.
I mean, all of our brushes are really awesome, but the one I always reach for is our detailer too.
100%.
And our detailer is really great too. We've kind of improved on it a little bit recently. Mm-hmm. It's a thinner, and it, like, when you take it out, you have to really look to see, like, there's not very many bristles in there, hairs in there, but my detailer, new and improved detailer, and my detailer too are my absolute must-haves.
Yes, they're great.
Mm-hmm. So someone's wanting to know who to contact in Australia for...
Well, they have a website, so you can go to their website, and it's actually uglyducklingnailsaustralia.com. Is it .com? Yeah, let's see. UglyDucklingNailsAustralia.com, and they'll have all their contact information there. Mm-hmm. I don't actually know offhand their email address.
Sorry, I have Marianne here wondering if we offer one-on-one classes. Yes, we do. Mm-hmm. For one-on-one class information, you can contact this lovely lady, Christina Kronk, at christina.uglyducklingnails@gmail.com.
Okay, so there's a question a while back, someone wanting to know if students are able to come to the 5K, and then also someone wanting to know how much it is.
Yes, and we did answer that one. Students, yes, of course. And
can I say just quickly too, because we forgot to mention, or maybe we did, but we are trying again to save this video to put it on YouTube, so that, because there are a lot of questions that people coming and going, it does make it kind of hard if you miss something. So we're hoping to be on our YouTube with this. Sorry, Christina, go ahead.
Yeah.
remember?
Oh, was it the cost?
Oh, the cost.
Yeah, so if you register and sign up before July 1st, it is $1,250, and then after that it's $1,500. And with that, it includes obviously amazing education. We'll have a light breakfast and lunch will be included, as well as a great.
Not a light lunch.
No, I said.
You said light lunch. Our lunch.
You said light breakfast and lunch.
Oh.
Okay, we really like teasing Christina.
The food will be really good. No, I do too. Oh, yeah, just not on camera.
Oh, I see.
Oh, anyway, are you on camera right
now? Oh, shoot. Yvonne's coffee's kicking in.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm the most mature one here.
Okay. I have Romina on Facebook. She says, I love your guys' acrylic line. I am now wanting to switch to your gel line. Is it the same process in preparation as the acrylic line? Meaning etching the natural nail plate, etc. And would you use your prep and primer too?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It is the exact same steps as our acrylic line. You want to use your prep and your primer after you've etched the natural nail plate, removed all visible traces of dust, debris, all that good stuff. You apply our prep, and then you apply our primer, and you're ready to go.
Mm-hmm. And I love our gel line, so you'll...
I do too.
Yes, and it's quite transformed.
Yeah, I have been, because I was a born and raised acrylic girl, and I love our gel, so I'm sure you're going to love it just as much.
But you know, that's something too, like when we've created this, it is, everybody kind of has their own thing, and I was talking about this the other day, about when I started a long time ago, we only had one color acrylic powder, there were no gels, and the acrylic that we had, you had to pick it up, the liquid up on your brush, put it on the nail, put in the powder, put that on the nail, and you had to actually go like this, and you
had to go. Oh my god! Scary. I can't wait to replay that. Sorry, I'm careful. That scared me. I was ready to jump over you too. Everyone for themselves. Hold on, I'm gonna fix that.
Okay, I'll finish talking about
that.
So we just, all we had was this one color acrylic, and you had to knead it really fast to mix it because it didn't self-mix. And then you'd have to tap it in and spread it. So we didn't have a lot. I have never really had a product that I couldn't work with. I've never had a problem with products. But people have, especially depending on what they're trained in, and people get comfortable with different things. What we've done is we've tried to do what we like. We know it works for us. And, I mean, we can't, beyond that, we can't guarantee anything other than we do what we like. And as working nail techs, we're continually working with it and using the product and improving as we can as we go along. And we're open to feedback, totally open. We've got a few things that we've changed. We've only been going for a year.
Yes.
So even in that year, we've had those few little bumps and bruises and
learning experiences.
Sure, and changing and adapting as we go along, and people put in requests and we make changes. And so we're happy to do that. We just really want to make it work for you as well.
Absolutely.
That is true.
Everybody's laughing at us on Facebook.
Oh,
what's going on? What happened?
Oh, just a little lighting.
A little technical difficulty.
Oh my
God. Stephanie, a little technically challenged.
Well, good at nails, not at technology.
Yeah.
Stephanie Nicholson asks, do you still send out samples of the gel, line, or acrylic? We do still have our sample kits, but actually we have improved them, and they are available for purchase on our website. All the information is listed on the website. They now include samples of our forms, our files, a prep, and a primer, and then the samples of the powders and liquid or our gel.
That's right.
And a cute little bag.
Well, there you go.
That's the topic.
I think we kind of found that really people needed to be using it. Wasn't just how the product worked as far as application, it was durability and everything. So we really felt that they needed to have the prep and primer and everything in order to give it an honest
try.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I know there was a question way back on Instagram regarding one of our, I guess, photos that we posted holding a black bottle and what that was. Our gel polish line.
The black bottle.
Yeah, the black bottle. So that is our gel polish. So we have a full gel polish line.
Oh,
Sarah!
Hi! Aww.
I love the cute little gifts you guys added to all the orders, too.
Oh, thank you.
Fun fact, that's Yvonne's mom that packs those for all you guys with lots of love.
She does.
She really takes the time to think about things for different holidays and stuff, so.
Absolutely.
Yeah, she loves her little job. She does. Mommy.
Shout out to Mama Wendy.
Yeah, Mama Wendy.
If we get this recorded, she'll be watching.
Yeah.
Because she doesn't do Instagram. Oh, she could be watching us on Facebook.
Maybe.
She might be there. She might be
Hi,
there.
Wendy, if you're out there.
Wendy. Hi, Wendy!
I don't think she knows how.
Aww, that's okay.
She's a little more old school than I am.
That's fair.
No, but you know what? She's pretty hip. Amy does her nails, and she does some really cool stuff.
Oh, yeah.
She's up for anything.
Always, always like the funky stuff.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I mean, it would be interesting to me to know how many people out there would feel like they want the support and just kind of to hang out for a half an hour, or whether they would rather be watching live demos. We kind of were thinking that with the demos that it's maybe better to have them recorded on YouTube, so that, because a lot of times when we're doing live demos, it's really hard to answer all the questions.
Absolutely.
So that was kind of our thought with doing this. We kind of thought we could be kind of like the little view, you know, just hang out and chat. And,
absolutely.
But we'd be interested to hear feedback from everybody if that works for them too.
Oh, absolutely. Hold up. I had to close my Facebook, so I'll be back. Don't anybody ask anything yet.
Have we got Instagram going too?
PrinceCreo07.
We have a great question for Yvonne.
Yes.
Oh, perfect. What do you guys look for when you choose to feature nails on our Instagram page?
So, okay, well, first of all, obviously quality nails. Mm-hmm. Lighting is really important, because I know a lot of times I'll look and there'll be pictures of nails that I really like, but the lighting's not good.
The clarity.
The clarity, the angle.
Absolutely.
It's always nice if we can get things that are a little bit unique, too, but still, even good structure, you know, structure's important. So the idea with it is that we want to post things that are inspirational to us and to you, right? So it's, our page is really more about inspiring people. Because even with us, you know, it's... I wish I had photos of when I first started.
I wish you did
nails,
too.
So I'm going to bring mine.
I'm pretty sure my first set.
We should share something. I have my book. Maybe we should do that next
That
week.
Would be so fun. So we can, everyone can see the nails that we used to do.
Oh gosh.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
So a lot of our lovely people on Facebook are chiming in and they're saying, I love the live demos. Love live demos, but this is great too. Would love to see a mix of both demos and chats.
Lots of people on Instagram saying demos.
Lots of demos.
Yeah, okay. So maybe
we're
we should ask what they want to see.
So maybe, actually, we can create a poll on our Facebook page.
Great.
I'll look into that.
Great.
And I'll get that up. Probably after we're done here.
Yeah, what kind of demos do people
And then each week we could do that and see what people choose to vote in for that week. That's kind of cool.
I think we like doing this too because we really like being interactive with you
100%.
Guys. Like, we love doing demos, but it's fun to sit and chat too. So
I know. That's true. I had a question about what is your favorite shape to create? So let's all go through ours. Natasha, what's
your Almond!
Almond!
Almond is my favorite. Square is my enemy.
Square.
You're so old school.
No, you know what, though? She's actually technically ahead of the times, because you know what's going to happen.
It's going to come
back.
It's
going to go full circle.
I don't think so.
Yes.
Really?
No.
I disagree.
This is like a debate. This is like The View.
Do you know what? Like, when I started doing nails in 3 years, nobody wore almond. Nobody. And remember when all it was pink and white, right? Everybody had pink and white. Now it's not very common.
My lovely client Stephanie is watching and she said, I volunteer to live feed my next appointment. I'm holding you to it.
Wow, very good, very good. We have, you ladies are great. Thank you for being so inspiring. I'm only 6 months in and love you, looking at your page and using your top coats. Thank you for answering my questions.
Aww. You're welcome. Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
And really, honestly, thank you. I always say I really believe it sounds always a little corny, but really we would be nothing without you guys.
It's true.
Yvonne tells that to us on a daily basis. And it's very true.
Yeah.
About everyone.
Absolutely. 100%.
Very thankful.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that is why we want to be here for your support. If you have any questions, product related, because I know there's a lot of questions that circulate on Facebook, and sometimes we're not always present or see the questions. So we want to be able to put ourselves out there and make ourselves available to answer those questions. And if not, you know, you can always reach us personally on our Facebook pages, email us for questions, because we're always here.
Yeah. I actually want to address something while we have kind of everybody here. Recently, we've just switched off the private messaging option on our Ugly Duckling Facebook page, just because Facebook is not that reliable sometimes when it comes to notifying us about new messages and stuff. And we would hate for anybody to feel like we're not getting back to them or anything like that, because sometimes, honestly, we miss things. So it's better if you contact us by calling us or sending us an email to any one of our emails, and we'll be
Any of the emails. The emails are all monitored really regularly.
Yeah.
But Facebook, I also find too, even with my personal one, I'll get a message that's like 3 weeks old.
You're correct. And I've noticed
really,
that too.
Yeah.
And I feel so bad not answering them, but I honestly didn't even know that a message had come through.
Yeah.
For sure.
Okay, so I have a suggestion here on Facebook. Just 1 second. I'm just saying hi to Carrie. Carrie's here. Carrie does some great reviews for us on her YouTube channel.
Hi, Carrie.
Oh, Melissa says, I just emailed Yvonne for a spot with 5K. Hopefully I hear back in time and don't miss out on the spot. I really want to attend. That's Melissa Vince, who we've been chatting with late.
Hi, Melissa. Hi. Once we're done here, I'll run and take care of that for you.
Okay, and then we have Yudira Rivera. I'm so sorry. I hope I'm not butchering anyone's names. All my female techs love your brushes, but my male techs feel the sequins in the brushes. If they came in black sequins, they would love it also. LOL. Can your brushes please be made this way?
Do you know, it's funny. I was just looking at doing black brushes just for that reason.
Oh, sorry. I was reading a comment and I missed this.
Do you want me to reread it?
Could you?
She says...
The boys want black.
Yes. Yadira says, all of us female techs love our pretty little brushes, but the men want some black ones.
And do they want black rhinestones or do they just want black?
Like...
Do they want
still crystals, or you want just like a black handle?
Because we can do either.
Yeah.
So whatever would be more popular for the men.
Okay.
We gotta think of our boys too.
And
absolutely.
Yeah.
That's
we
true.
Do.
You know what? That's a good.
Good. Thank you.
Thing though. So we've had some requests for baby boomers.
On Facebook too.
Oh, so yeah. We have a new baby boomer.
You can do it in gel.
We have a new baby boomer.
And I'll do it in acrylic
color.
Oh, we do.
Oh, I shouldn't have said that because now everybody's going to be asking for
it. Well, you know what, Yvonne? You said it. You said it, Yvonne.
No, can you rewind that part?
Take the floor. It's yours.
Okay, give us a hard time now. We slip up.
Yvonne, show the baby.
Okay, so I'm seeing demos for shaping nails for new nail techs, and Susan says gel.
Okay, gel. So we are definitely going to be putting a poll up after our live feed is done. Give us about...
Absolutely. And you know what? I'll tell you right now, for shaping, I'm on the gel.
You're on the gel.
She's on the acrylic.
But shaping, okay, so are we talking about actually sculpting it or shaping with a file?
The same with gel and acrylic.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I can shape with the file.
No, I think Yvonne is the OG of nails.
Really?
So actually, you know what would be fun with it, you guys?
Can you show us
the original? I can learn how to do that. The original gangster.
Should do the backfill challenge. You have to see who can do a proper backfill on one hand the quickest, from prep to
Sealer. Can I be honest?
What?
I feel very confident in that.
Oh, I think that, you know what?
Christina's ready to throw down.
Christina, okay, the slowest at nails. Super.
I feel confident.
So do I.
If you guys want to see a challenge like that from all four of us,
that would be fun. I can. I say I can do it.
No, I think Christina and I should go head to head.
20 minutes.
We should have, okay.
One hand?
Yes.
Yeah, well, I used to book.
20 minutes, okay.
I used to book.
Actually, that's what Christy did it in. Christy Beacon did it in about 20 minutes, I think, or just under 20 minutes. I think it was like 17 minutes. So let's see, let's organize that.
With gel polish on it,
but
so
you
just know that.
It also
depends. Perfect.
But it also depends on the nails that your back filling.
Well, they have to make sure they're lift
decent.
Yeah.
So maybe 1 week. Me and Amy can be models for these two. And then another
good
week,
idea.
They can be models for us.
I'm going up against
and
the
then, and then the two, the, whoever is the fastest yeah. will go against each other.
Perfect.
For the ultimate championship.
Should we make
so
a
wait,
trophy?
Hold on. Whose nails would I be doing?
No, me and you are going to be models for them.
Mm-hmm.
So then
whoever,
be models for us.
So whoever wins.
I don't want Christina's nails.
Yeah,
what
she's going to
be
like this. She's like, ooh.
Ow, 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 ow.
Ow.
Never be able
okay,
to get them
we
done.
That we
yeah, we're live here.
Sorry.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Someone asked.
Wondering if we ever get any work done.
No, we don't.
Someone asked a good question. How
yes.
do you remove gel for a new set of gel polish nails with a file or Sani-Ban?
Sani-Ban. I do on a very low speed, a medium grip Sani-Ban.
I do mine with a file.
On a
She's always going against what we say.
Always.
Standing back.
Sure.
It's the quickest way.
If you're comfortable with an e-file.
Yes, yes.
If you're not comfortable with an e-file, then do it with a hand file.
That's good point, because you don't want to cause any trauma to the natural nail.
That's
damage.
True. And especially if you're doing it on natural nail. Did
yes.
she say natural
I think
nail?
It was over enhancement, wasn't it?
If it's enhancement, that's something. But natural nail, you have to be really confident with your e-file if you're using it
that's
to
true.
Remove gel polish.
Excuse
on.
Me, I thought it was over an enhancement.
Stephanie Lilly says, would love to see basic sculpting videos to go along with the written instructions for each product, particularly Otis Monomer, regular Monomer, and so on.
It's on the list.
We are very
busy.
Honestly, do you
we're
know
trying.
What happened is that really when we started this, and I mean, I've been distributing and manufacturing product for, oh gosh, like over 25 years. And, when I started this, I had no idea. I've never had anything go as crazy as this has, and we've been so busy just keeping up with things. And so those intentions are all there, and I think this is going to be the year to get those things done.
And we will.
We
yes.
will. Yeah, we are
this
definitely
week.
Trying. I'm slowly...
Tell them how much I nag you guys.
All the time. I do have a YouTube channel right now, and I'm slowly starting to add videos. I only have a couple gel polish tutorials right now, but... we're getting there. I have videos that
need
to be edited.
You need to change your name on it, too.
I didn't change it? Is it just Natasha Harton?
No, I don't think it is. It's that number and letter thing.
Oh, it should. I tried.
Oh,
I
did you?
YouTube
oh, maybe
speed.
I need to check.
And then if you type in Natasha Harton on YouTube, my page will come. Bob Real says, my wife follows you on everything, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. I would love to give her a great gift from your company. She's a big fan of yours. Well, tell your wife we thank her very much for her support. Paulette Pep. Oh, your Auntie Paulette.
Is that my Auntie Polly?
Yeah.
Who else is there? Is everyone watching all my aunts? It's true. They're all together tonight.
No. Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. So funny.
Aw. Which is normal for you, Josh.
There seems to be a delay here, is there?
No, this is nobody's commented since then.
What?
I just read the
is
last
this Facebook one. Or Instagram?
This is Facebook.
Oh, okay. Is that Instagram?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, we got a lot of filing and shaping requests, so that is great. I'm super excited about that.
Are we getting...
Your Auntie Paulette says, I'm here with your mom and Nana. Hey, Phil!
Hey,
Nana! What are your...
Ooh, this is a good one!
What are your nail trend predictions?
Oh, that's
okay.
easy.
Well, we just said square.
Yeah.
Oh, like shape wise?
No,
or?
Just in general. Like, Destiny, do you mean like nail art or shapes or everything?
I know exactly what I'm going to say. You go
what?
First.
No, you go.
I think everything and anything that people can find in nature that they can fit in nails. I think the weirdest but cool things. Because I know things like we saw scorpions a little bit coming into the nails, like anything I feel, anything I can find that's thin enough to inlay, I think will be the thing.
I draw a line of bugs, though.
Oh, for sure. Okay,
I think, I mean, as of right now, I know that we've all kind of talked about it, and I'm loving it. There's a lot of inspiration from nature.
100%.
Like natural stone and, yeah, and florals and that kind of stuff, mm-hmm, and I really, really like that. Because you Destiny says, because everything right now is really loud and crazy. And actually, a lot of my clients before would get really extravagant nail art and lots, yeah, of bling and crazy stuff, totally, and they've totally toned it down. Mm-hmm. Like, most of them now just want a one polish gel color,
yes,
maybe a feature nail. Feature nails are still a big
They're
thing.
Great.
Well, it gives you a little something,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So I think my... what I think is it's going to go a lot more back to the one color. Like, we're seeing that, but I know
yeah,
we're posting on Instagram and that we're starting to get back into just people want the simple classic.
It's true.
It is true. And it's funny.
And those are always the ones that get all the likes.
Yeah. And the thing is you're right, because I remember even not so long ago, I was doing tons of glitter inlays, and that's all I did. I was always grabbing stuff from my drawer. And then there went for like a 6-month period where I didn't touch any glitter. It was all natural one color gel polish. So it's interesting to see how the trends since I've been in school have been rotating,
mm-hmm,
which is very interesting to me.
It's not
that's
very awesome.
I swear it's going to come back.
Oh,
and I honestly think... you know, like when you used to be, you know, take
the
flowers.
Ducktails.
No, no, that was a terrible thing to say. Don't put any ideas up there, everyone.
Gosh,
you know when you used to take flowers and you would press them in, you know,
your book.
Like, no,
like dried flowers.
You would take like
parchment
like paper or something. You
wax paper.
Thank
wax.
You. And you know, you
put them in your book.
Yes, I guess
that's what I just said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
But it wasn't. So when it comes from Yvonne, it's right, but when I say it, it's wrong.
Yes.
Okay. Late done nail design.
Mm-hmm.
I can't see. I don't have my glasses on. You guys should do extreme challenge to see how long nails hold up in extreme sports like Christine Meekin did. I see you girls bungee jumping and skydiving.
Oh! My dad wants me to skydive this summer.
No.
I'm going there in July.
Okay, so are you going to go long?
For Vegas, I am, and then I go see my dad a week after.
You know what we should do?
Zip line.
Yes.
Are you going to do it?
Oh,
you're
yeah,
in front
yeah, yeah,
of
yeah.
people. If you pound this right now, it's done.
Woo!
We are going zip lining down Fremont Street in Vegas with long nails, and we are going to vlog it.
Yes.
And see if we
yes.
can live stream it too on one of our phones.
That would be super fun. And we're going to do long.
Well, these are short for me.
Double form it.
These
what?
Are short.
Why not?
These are like tiny little itty bitty.
No.
These are bitten nails for you.
I get to do Yvonne's nails for Vegas.
Do you?
Okay.
But I just was going to say, like, I know, I can say, I was thinking about that today because I was out working on the little, on our little mini farm and with my hammer and nail and screw gun and all of that and thinking, you know, I can't even remember the last time I broke a nail.
It's true. And you wear them so thin. She's gardening in them, she's digging in the rocks, she's feeding her animals,
she's
rock climbing, building fences,
skydiving.
And I'm not kidding when I say she has very thin nails.
Skydiving's not the problem with long nails, it's the landing.
Or the guy I'm jumping tandem with, because my nails will be like this.
Oh, the poor dude. He's not going to want to go with you. He's going to look at your nails and be like,
yeah,
no, next.
Get out of here. Sue, I'm sorry, I can't pronounce your last name, but Garens,
mm-hmm.
I just don't want to butcher anything. Do you think with one color there will be more stripe and tape? I hope not. You know what, I bought a bunch of it and I got really mad with it and I put it away.
You were optimistic for a little bit.
I'm feeling better now,
me?
Actually.
Not so much.
I think I find if our gel polish, I like how it doesn't have much of a dispersion layer.
Yeah.
It works great for... transfer foil, and I found that with our gel polish, it actually holds the striping tape in place really well. As long as you cut a little bit shorter and then seal it properly, it works really good. It's
I think you have to inlay it. You gotta inlay it.
I do 2 coats of sealer over top, and
do you?
Knock on wood, it seems to be pretty good.
Hold on, I just thought of something.
What's that?
Someone just said duck nails need to die already. And I just thought, well, maybe not. They're duck nails.
That's
what
I said.
Oh, yeah, duck nails.
That's what I just said.
I didn't get that.
Yeah.
Oh,
say duck,
Christina.
Duck nails. One thing, as much as we are the ugly ducklings, we You will never wear duck nails.
No, I'm
maybe,
sorry.
Maybe nothing personal against people who wear duck nails. No. It just wouldn't work for us. And in fact, one thing that I find interesting, because I wore my nails square for 35 years, and then I went to quite pointy and oval, and I always thought that square would be a lot easier to manage things, like pick things
not,
up.
It's not.
But it's not.
Perfect. Having those corners really, and it's only like a fraction of the size on your nail, that corner, but it really.
And I don't find any difference in the strength of the nail with the shape at all.
I actually prefer almond just because I can get a really good, square you can get a really good pinch too, but you kind of run the risk of over pinching it, whereas almond I can get a good pinch and a nice C-curve and they're really strong.
And come back to the predictions of trends, I know also too, shaping, different shapes.
Yeah.
The same on every finger, I like that.
Oh, right. Yeah.
I really think that's cool. 100%.
I think also too, because we're really starting to become very influenced by Russian nail structure and Russian shaping and stuff here in Canada, finally, in Northern America. North America.
Some of the things that we're going to be learning at the 5K are really extreme shapes, but they're not necessarily for everybody wearing every day, but it just improves your techniques and your, what's the word I'm looking for?
Your portfolio.
Okay, that wasn't the word, but it'll work.
Even just being able to know how to do it, right? It'll help you perfect more everyday shapes.
It's amazing when you look back at your work even a year ago. Like, I see pictures coming up on Facebook this was 2 years ago, and I look at my nails thinking, wow, like, I know I've come a long way, and I just couldn't believe, like, at that time, you grow with your skill, right? And it's cool to see that, for sure.
Well, one thing that's great, like I said about the two of you, right from the beginning, I knew with you guys, because you both bring something unique, that your strengths to the table, right? So it's perfect when you go out and teach as a team, because you both have your unique strengths that really work well together.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Aww, he wants me, I'm so lovely. She's a lovely ducky.
She's the mother duck.
It's good. Is anything going over there on Instagram?
Christina's just saying hi to her mom.
My mom says prep.
Is that your mom? Sassy PJ 58. That's Christina's mom, everybody. Have to add her.
Speaking of PJs, we were just saying we're going to have a pajama party one day.
Yes, we are.
And come in our PJs.
And we're going to bring our ducky snuffies.
We have to find ducky snuffies now that Christina said that.
I know. I tend to do that a lot.
Any business tips that you wish you knew when you started?
Well,
yeah, actually, do we have all night?
I'm just kidding,
but there's a lot.
You're not kidding.
I'm not kidding, actually.
Go ahead.
Natasha can write a book.
I think we all could. I just think, as working professionals, I think we just need to value ourselves and know that, because at Duckling Nails, our passion here is to promote lots of education. Why do we do that? Because we want to be able to give opportunity to other nail techs to be able to better themselves, to better their skill, and in turn, to provide better services for their clients. And when you take education like that, it's going towards your benefit. So I think just knowing what your worth is and charging your worth. Yvonne, would you like to elaborate a little bit?
Well, I'd like to say something from the other side, is that I think it's really important. One thing that I always say, the girls will know, I always say this, why should people come to us? Mm-hmm. And it's the same if you're a nail tech. Why should people come to you? What are you offering them that's different from the person down the street? Like for us, we really work on our support and our service. We know there's a lot of good products out there, a lot of good companies. Mm-hmm. We don't focus on them. What we do is we focus on us and doing the best job that we can do here. And I think it's the same thing as a nail tech. When I hear nail techs say they can't build a clientele or they're not busy, you need to stop and evaluate why. Because if you are offering the service and educating yourself and looking after your customers, I think those are big things. If you do all that, take care of people, you'll have no problem.
Because like Yvonne said, no matter what, you come from a small town, you know, there's lots of business to go around. It's just how you...
Not even a small town.
Yeah. And don't worry about what other people do. Like, yeah. We don't worry about what other people do.
Yeah.
We just try and take care of what we're doing for you the best we can.
Absolutely.
Which is why we're always open to support, or to comments and suggestions.
Mm-hmm. Okay, two questions here.
Yes.
Where, when, and why Vegas? Someone's wondering if it's the IBS show. And then the other question is, where do we get our inspiration from?
Where do we get our inspiration from?
Okay, we should do the
Vegas is July, and it's actually not the IBS. It's actually a buyer's show, so it's for us. It's a bit different. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not. Yeah, it's a manufacturer's show.
And where do we get our inspiration for what we do?
No. Where do you get your inspiration for life, Christina?
For dinner, Christina.
Okay, it's late here and we're all getting a little tired.
At dinner, I'm overthinking the question.
Okay, where do you get your inspiration from? Me.
Okay, can I actually, no. Thank you.
Someone's getting their candy.
It is true. I will be honest, because all of us, Amy, Natasha, and myself, we are lucky that we are able to work alongside Yvonne. Because she... No, I'm serious. I've always said it from day one, because I remember Yvonne took a little bit of time off in the industry and she came back. And the day that I got the phone call, she was coming back. You have no idea how excited I was. Because she, honestly, she has such a good heart. She's caring for others. She takes care of her customers. I have to say this. She's sit there and take it. She is my biggest mentor in this industry, because I learn from her every day, and I think that is why we're so lucky to be able to work alongside you, because if I could be half of who you are when I'm, you know, at the end of my career, I'll feel like I've made it.
I say that, it's true.
You keep us very grounded, and you show us what really matters in life and what actually matters at the end of the day. It's true.
Hundies.
To my clients, and I know my client Stephanie is watching, so Stephanie, chime in after I say this. Mm-hmm. Yvonne comes in every morning when I'm doing my clients.
I need to leave.
No, you don't. Yvonne comes in. People need to know how you are, because
it's
you
true.
Are...
Yes, they do. They do.
I do the clients here on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. And every morning and every client throughout the day, Yvonne takes time out of her schedule, and she's literally running around her like a crazy lady. Takes time out of her schedule to come in and say hi to every client, ask if they need coffee, water, how they're doing. She remembers what's going on with them. She takes the time to talk to them. And every time she leaves, I say, I am so blessed to be able to work with Yvonne. And I've learned so much. And there's been times where Christine and I have been out working or away, and you know, we're not sure about something, and we phone her, and she always guides us in the right direction.
100%. And the thing is,
okay, they don't want to hear about me.
We love you. Well, they need to have inspiration, and if we don't have that kind of inspiration and support, it's really hard for us to focus on other things.
If you don't love your job and you don't love coming to work, then you're not going to feel inspired, and you are the foundation for that. So, we get a lot of inspiration from Yvonne.
That's true.
And then...
Where do we get inspiration for our designs?
For our designs.
Oh, that's me too.
For me, I get inspiration from a lot of Japanese nail artists. I've always really loved Japanese nail art. I love their style. Not necessarily like the Harajuku or whatever, I'm sorry. A lot, like, they have put a lot of, like, Hello Kitty and stuff on. Not so much that, but a lot of their hand-painted stuff with gel polish. It just blows me away to see how they layer things and combine things to create such beautiful, tiny little works of art. Of course, Sarah Elmes, Get Buff, she's an inspiration to a lot of people. Nature, fashion.
And I would say, like, I know, like, I'm obsessed with Home Diva.
Their
work is amazing, and it's just, it's really cool to see how everyone has such a cool, different, unique style to their nails. And honestly, for me, my huge inspiration, and I'm hoping to push forward in the future is all the Russian nail structure. I think it's absolutely fascinating. And is it practical to wear? No. I would love to do.
Wear.
Well, that's good to know. But my clients personally wear. I think it's just. To me, I'm in love. So that is what inspires me. Is all the Russian nail art. I absolutely love it.
Well, and you like doing. You like structure too.
I do.
That's me as well. Like, yeah. I like structure.
Yeah.
Somebody asked, do you ever struggle with your originality when trying to do designs?
Sometimes,
keeping
yes.
it original, yeah.
Actually, a lot of the times, yes. Mm-hmm. Because if you go on Instagram,
it's all been done.
Instagram, it's updating constantly. Every yeah. second, somebody's uploading something. So you may think you have this original idea, and then you're searching for Instagram, and somebody's already done it. Mm-hmm. So sometimes it's like, oh, I feel like I'm copying them. But then if you put your own spin on it, I don't know, it can be hard sometimes to mm-hmm. to get original ideas. And then you get excited about it, and you do it, and then it's like, oh.
You know what I think is funny is all these new ideas that are coming out that we were doing 30 years ago, 35
foils.
Years ago. Yeah.
Dried flowers. Sure. Yeah. Oh my gosh, transfer foils and inlaid dried flowers were big when the three of us were in nail school. Mm-hmm. Do you remember
right.
that?
Yeah.
The dried flowers? I was like, oh my gosh, you have a real flower in your nail?
Yeah. And you know, honestly, there's so much inspiration out there. It's just we don't have time to name it all. And that is why with our Instagram page, that's why we feature all these different nail artists, because everyone has their own twist and artistic abilities, and that is what's cool to be able to share and get ideas from, mm-hmm. really. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we have been,
live
for a little while.
Yeah.
We still have
time to say goodnight.
Well, it's up to you guys.
So basically, I think what we'll do is, like Natasha said, we'll do a poll on Facebook and get an idea of what people want to see. Maybe
yeah.
do that kind of like on a weekly basis so we know. And then maybe every once in a while, we'll kind of do the live thing here, questions and answers.
And actually, I was going to say, if people want to email any questions that they'd like us
True.
To address live too.
That actually might be a good thing, and then we can have a list of all the questions and just address them.
Why
like
don't
that.
We put... That's
well, we have
a
Facebook group
totally.
Also, so
we do
know.
Have an Ugly Duckling Facebook group mm-hmm. if you want to
which is
join
different
that
from our
as
page.
Well, which is different from our page. It's a group that you can come on and post questions and mm-hmm. and interact with other nail techs
100%,
as well.
100%, yeah.
Yeah. And our YouTube channel, we're going to try and see if we can share this for people who maybe... missed out on some of the questions, want to fast forward to a certain spot.
Mm-hmm. And people who might just want to just, you know, watch us for fun. Over and over.
We have fun. We hope you guys have fun. It's, you know, it's always awkward. That's why I'm like, we've been on here for
well,
an hour.
We
think we're funny.
We do. I laugh at ourselves when I rewatch our videos, but I don't think anyone else does.
Oh, okay, because we know what's really happening. Okay, well, do you think it's time to say goodnight? Does anybody
so.
Have any last questions?
Yeah, any
just
last questions?
Sign off for the night.
Maybe wait a second to see if anybody has any last minute questions. And then if you are thinking of questions for our next live Q&A, then you can always email them to...
The other thing I'd like to know... Mm-hmm. Contact.
Contact.
contact.uglyduckling@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm. And just put the title as live Q&A.
I'm wondering if people prefer Saturday nights or if they prefer the Thursday afternoons that we were doing.
I think it reaches anybody, depending, because we do it earlier in the day on Thursdays, and you know, so
yeah.
It's hard to really say.
Okay.
But one last question just to tie it off here. Just for people having issues with lifting, shaping, all that kind of thing, what I suggest is practice, practice, practice. The only way you're going to get better and feel more confident in your work is to be able to practice. And even myself, when I feel like, oh, I want to try something new and try something different, I don't have anyone to work on, I will take out my hand trainer and I will do nail after nail and just practice my shaping, because that's the only way you're going to improve and feel confident in yourself.
Can I add to that quickly though? If people want to send us photos, we often get people sending photos of their nails. It really helps to see actual pictures of what you're mm-hmm. doing if you're having problems. And often mm-hmm. it's just a couple simple things that we can say to you that will help you.
Tweak it a
yeah.
bit. Yeah, for sure.
Because lifting, if you're having lifting, there's a reason.
For sure.
And I know people, like, they think that maybe it's the products that they're using. Like I say, there's a lot of good products out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's usually technique. Sometimes it's your client's nails.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I always say, you're working with a different canvas every time because everyone's nail bed is a different shape, length, so it's all going to apply differently.
Okay, so a couple last questions here. Sure. Okay, any advice for newly licensed nail techs like myself? And then someone also asked, what makes her... I'd love some more business info for people starting out.
Okay, so maybe we addressed that earlier.
Okay.
And maybe specifically what kind of business info, new nail techs starting out, you know, we were talking about servicing and looking after people, education.
Education is huge. Make sure you take classes, just keep practicing. Don't, when you're not at work, if you have time at home, just get out your hand trainer or work on yourself and just keep practicing.
And I find too with the past of training students, if you're not keeping up with it on a daily basis, you're not going to build a clientele real fast, real quick. You need to keep practicing because if you stop or take a break in between, it's easier to fall out, so you've got to keep going.
Well, even for us, if you take a week or 2 weeks holiday and you come back, it's going to take you longer.
I'm slower.
It takes a couple of days to get back into the rhythm, right?
For sure.
So you want to keep your hand in it constantly.
Especially for beginner techs, absolutely. Yeah.
My biggest piece of business advice for somebody that's just starting out, we mentioned this earlier, set your prices and stick to them and know your worth and charge your worth because it's very easy to let that start to slip and slide.
I need to say something.
Okay.
I need, talking about pricing, we can have a whole other thing on pricing because that's something that I'm really passionate about. And I know, like, when I started doing nails, I'm butting in.
You know, go for it.
When I started doing nails, I charged half, there was only two other nail techs in town, but I charged half of what they charge. And by the time I actually finished working at the desk, I was charging double what people were charging. And that was with the support of somebody who really encouraged me and said, Yvonne, what are you doing? You should not be turning away clients. And I see this all the time from people saying not accepting new clients. If you're at a place, if you're starting out and you're learning, charge less. It puts too much pressure on yourself if you're charging the same as really experienced nail techs. Get your practice up, know that you're kind of apprenticing, even if you're just with yourself, you should be charging less. And I feel if you're working for a salon, that salon should be allowing you to charge less. If you are an experienced nail tech and you have a full clientele, you're not charging enough. And people will pay you. And I know, like I've said this to the girls, and I understand because I struggled with putting my prices up too. It was really hard for me, but you know what? You're worth it. You need a raise. You work hard. And if you're turning people away, you shouldn't be.
A couple of people have asked just about how to get our products and register. So maybe we can close with that.
Absolutely. Okay. So you can visit our website at www.uglyducklingnails.com. There is a tab at the top that's labeled register. Just click that, and then it'll lead you to our email that you can send your credentials to. So we do require, since we are a professionals only brand, we require you to send us an email photo of your certificate or your license or a link to your social media page, business card, something to prove that you're a working professional. Mm-hmm. And then we can send you the link to finish the registration for your account. And then you're able to log in and view pricing and order.
That sounds wonderful, Natasha.
And we ship internationally.
Yes, we ship internationally.
All around the world.
And hopefully we'll have this on YouTube, so if you have questions that you came in late and didn't hear, you can always, like I say, get on there, fast forward. I think we're out of time. Instagram's gonna kick us off anyway.
Okay, thanks for joining the Duckies,
everybody.